Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us all our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel. Is it my way that is unfair? Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life. Since he has turned away from all the sin that he has committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
know your ways. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are the God of my salvation. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your compassion, O Lord, and your merciful love, for they are from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth, nor my transgressions. In your merciful love, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. He shows the way to sinners. He guides the humble in right judgment. To the humble he teaches his way. Remember your mercies, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Speak, Lord, your servant.
said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord. I've always liked this gospel, maybe because I see myself in it. And that's one of the ways when studying and praying scripture, Lectio Divina is prayerfully go over the reading and go back and see where you fit in the story and read it again prayerfully and the like. And what I mean by it reminds me of myself is that I know there have been many times when I have, in short-sightedness, not short-temperedness, but just too quick to respond, I guess is the best way to put it, would say, "No, I can't do that, I don't want to do that, I'm not able to do that." And then I go away and I have remorse. I wish I would have thought more closely or clearly before I said my no, that I certainly could do it. Many times I've gone back then, and like that first son, after saying no, I go back and I do what needs to be done. I think a lot of us are like that. We have remorse for things we could have done or could have said or should have said or should have done. And Jesus is making it clear that, again, he knows we struggle with this. He knows we struggle with this. Now, and so he's saying the one says no and then has remorse and goes back and works in the vineyard. The other says yes, and then he goes off and does his own thing. Which one did the will of the Father? Well, it's pretty clear the one that said no did the will of the Father. It's kind of a little twist. It ties in with that first reading from Ezekiel, where it talks about fairness. The fact is that, again, we shall know redemption when we have said our no and then changed our mind and done the right thing. But if we said our yes and then go off and do our own thing, there'll be a price to pay, there'll be a judgment. Jesus hammers at home in his gospel in another way. He's pointing out to them that yes, they're the religious people, they're the good people, they're the holy people. They say yes to God. And then when Jesus comes on the scene, they turn away. They turn away. They don't recognize him. They don't want to recognize him, as maybe put more accurately, they don't want to recognize him. And Jesus is saying, look at these prostitutes and tax collectors. They said, in a sense, their no to God by their behavior, to God's will. But then when John the Baptist came on the scene, and now me, they are saying their yes. They experience conversion, a change of heart. And they're going to be better off in God's kingdom than you, who think you're so holy and religious. Because they heard John's voice and repented. They recognized Jesus and knelt at his feet. where you refuse to see the signs around you of God's hand, God's working. And so maybe for us today, it's simply looking at the times that we are offered where we could say our yes and do the right thing. The sacrament of penance is a good place for people that say yes and for people who say no. For people who say no and then do the right thing, they can confess their no. For people who say yes and then go and do their own thing, they can confess that. God's grace is available to all. It's abundant and it's merciful. And so today, as we hear of the two sons, let us consider the times we have had remorse. And the other thing is not to be afraid to change our minds when we said no and then go back and do the right thing. It's like going back to someone and telling them, you know I said this, but I do have the time and I can do this for you. It would still be helpful. So don't be prideful. And that's what got Herod in trouble. He was prideful. That he was afraid after he said one thing, he was afraid to change his mind. Don't be afraid to change your mind. If you said no and then you realized it was the wrong thing, then say your yes and apologize and do the right thing. That's the message for today. And that's what the Lord holds out to us. He wants us to say our yes to the Father's will and our yes to working in the vineyard, not unlike the passages of the gospel that we've had the past few Sundays, about working in the vineyard, doing the Father's will, going out and doing the day's labor, and saying our yes to God's will, even after at first we might have said no. I believe
in one God,
Father Almighty, Maker of the earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For our sin and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Mindful of God's grace and call to work in the vineyard, we need God's help. And so we present our prayers and petition.
That the church will continue to call sinners back into the fold of God's faithful people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That secular leaders will know and follow God's ways and lead under his authority. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That first responders, doctors, and nurses, and military members at home and abroad will be protected in their duties. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this 40 days for life campaign will bring awareness and assistance to the needs of the unborn and their mothers and fathers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those undergoing Christian persecution and those searching for a safe home will know an increase in courage and receive timely help. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may know the comfort of Christ the healer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may experience God's mercy, especially Catherine Turbert. And at this Mass, we remember Leonard Kowalczyk. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the silent petitions of our hearts may be answered according to God's will. For these we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask all these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Oh,
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Lord, we pray from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory to Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Confessions will be heard this Sunday morning, immediately after the 8, 10, and 12 o'clock Masses. Life Team kickoff will be this Sunday at 6 p.m. More details are in the bulletin. If you are able to help sanitize the church after Mass today, please consider staying for a few minutes to assist. To help with this sanitizing, please put down the kneelers only where you are seated, or someone who has left with you. Thank you for celebrating the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Mass here at St. Mary's. May God bless you and keep you safe.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thank you.
And you now are a prince of the heavenly hosts by the power.